Now I have a similar talk. Again, superficial punctate keratitis and subepithelial infiltrates. These are a group of disorders characterized by changes in corneal epithelium, Bowman's membrane, and superficial stroma. There is a this is a common sign of various diverse disease entities. So it is important to know what all can cause it. Morphological types could be punctate epithelial erosions, punctate epithelial keratitis, punctate subepithelial infiltrates. Punctate epithelial erosions are true exfoliations of corneal epithelium which appear as fine depressions and pit under high magnification. Histologically, there is a degeneration of epithelial cells with surrounding edema, but that there are no infiltrates and there is no loss of transparency. Cornea appears clear, but punctate lesions stain well with fluorescein. They cause discomfort, foreign body sensation, photophobia, and lacrimation. Punctate epithelial keratitis are gray and white, well-circumscribed lesions which may be slightly elevated and visible on slit lamp. Histological, there are discrete infiltrates in the epithelium consisting of polymorphonuclear cells and later lymphocytes with intra and intercellular edema. Lesions stain well with fluorescein in irregular manner. They stain better with rose bengal. It is generally associated with punctate epithelial erosions, and they can be classified into fine, coarse, areolar, and stellate depending on the shape. Punctate subepithelial infiltrates are again gray-white, well-circumscribed spots located in more superficial layers of stroma. That means they are deeper compared to other lesions. And histologically, they consist of leukocytes just below the Bowman's layer, occasionally in Bowman's layer itself. Generally, the changes appear to be mild and permanent scarring is absent, as you see in adenoviral keratitis. But sometimes when it is associated with staphylococcal blepharoconjunctivitis, severe necrosis and scarring is prominent. And these generally follow punctate epithelial erosions and keratitis, and they tend to persist for a longer time and are stain negative. There is another related disorder called filamentary keratopathy, which is characterized by fine filaments of corneal epithelium and mucus, which stain well with fluorescein and rose bengal. They may evolve from punctate keratopathy and may be associated with it. Histologically, there are areas of Bowman's membrane disruption where epithelium becomes loose, and these sites attract mucus and debris and form filaments. Why do we need to find the cause? Because the treatment would vary according to the cause. Bacterial infection of conjunctiva and lids like blepharitis and meibomitis, and these are to be treated with lid scrubs and systemic tetracycline with artificial tears, while adenoviral keratoconjunctivitis will have to be treated with topical steroid. Herpes simplex would need different management. Differential diagnosis would include dry eye syndrome. So for diagnosing this, you have to do tear film breakup time, Schirmer's test. Rosacea keratitis, acne rosacea on the face is diagnostic. Ritter's syndrome and chlamydial infection, take the relevant history. Allergic and vernal keratoconjunctivitis will have a typical history. Superior limbic keratoconjunctivitis, Thaksin superficial punctate keratopathy, contact lens induced keratitis, mechanical trauma like trichiasis and entropion, so lid examination is important, radiation keratopathy. Chemical injuries can directly lead to these lesions, or later in the course of the disease, they may be because of limbal stem cell deficiency. Keratitis medicamentosa also present with punctate epithelial erosions. Neurotrophic keratitis as in herpes zoster and trigeminal neuralgia. Exposure keratitis may also present like this. And ocular surface disorders like SGS and OCP often present like punctate erosions. This is a case where trichiasis is causing punctate keratitis. This is a case of Steven Johnson syndrome, where you can see the lid margin keratinization. This is an initial phase, but diagnostic is punctate keratopathy in the region where the eyelid is rubbing the cornea. Meibomitis can be associated with the punctate erosion, so eyelids have to be examined. This is a case of dry eye with diffuse punctate keratitis. And sometimes you have microsporidial keratitis, which can be confused with punctate epithelioplasty. and there are superficial elevated lesions on the cornea. And in fact, microsporidial keratitis can be focal diffuse, and this is what, and diagnosis is made by corneal scraping. And herpetic keratitis can also present like punctate lesions, or it can present with dendritic lesions. This is a typical adenoviral keratitis with superficial infiltrate. This is what they look like. Subepithelial infiltrates can be there in a graft also, as you can see here. And adenoviral keratitis sometimes looks like can cause graft rejection, and it can be confused. Adenoviral keratitis can be confused with stromal graft rejection also. This is a nummular keratitis, which is also a type of subepithelial infiltrates. These are superficial infiltrates in a patient with herpes zoster ophthalmicus, which appeared after the keratitis had healed. These are infiltrates post-LASIK. This is DLK post-LASIK, PISK. The other condition that you need to differentiate is superficial corneal dystrophy, which can mimic like infiltrate, or you have recurrent corneal erosion syndrome. History taking, it is important to take systemic history like rheumatoid arthritis, collagen vascular disease, skin diseases like rosacea and Stevens-Johnson syndrome, genitourinary discharge in Ritter syndrome, UV light exposure, atopic disease history, sudden onset or gradual onset of disease, unilateral or bilateral. Eyelid have to be examined properly for blepharitis, meibomitis, entropion, trichiasis. Inadequate lid closure leading to exposure keratitis. Lacrimal punctum is dilated and inflamed in actinomyces and other infections. And skin lesions suggestive of rosacea, SJS, and seborrheic dermatitis. Conjunctiva, you should look for hyperemia, papillary hypertrophy, and xerosis. Comprehensive clinical examination should look for distribution of lesions, stromal involvement, corneal sensation becomes important in herpetic keratitis and tear film examination. Treatment is generally aimed at most probable cause. Lid hygiene is important because lid abnormalities can be primary, or they with recurrent inflammation, eyelids tend to get inflamed. So you have to treat them accordingly. Tarsorrhaphy and lid constructive surgery in case it is exposure keratitis or neurotrophic keratitis. Preservative free artificial tears are important. Bandage contact lens as and when needed. Scleral contact lens are a mainstay of treatment in keratitis associated with SJS. And mucous membrane and minor salivary gland transplant may be employed. To sum up, in case of punctate keratopathy, careful history taking, examination of patient as a whole, and complete eye examination including lid and adnexa, including lacrimal glands, help you arrive at a diagnosis. Once diagnosed, treatment is modified accordingly, and patient should also be educated for need of frequent instillation of drops and need for continued follow-ups. Thank you.